joined a journey, traveling the country and experiencing creativity and art demonstrations. And now, we're live in a city near you, whoever you might be. It's the Kraaft It Live Art Concert, an art show with fun, laughter, and a few mistakes thrown in too. Follow along on Instagram and see behind-the-scenes images by D-Dog, fielding your YouTube questions, Sylvia and Mr. Crafter. And now, your host, Heather Crafter.
Hello and welcome. Oh, I just got the hold on and wait. Whoops, shit. Don't. I didn't say welcome yet. Okay. All right. Now welcome. Hi. I didn't wait for the signal. So typical Kraaft It Live. Made a mistake already. So welcome to Kraaft It Live. Sorry, we still don't have a face cam. All you get is the workstation cam, Sylvia and Heather hands. The hand cam. That's all that you get right now until we figure out why the software isn't working right. But hopefully you can see my little sketch of a basket of Mayflowers. Because today's May 1st. Did you know that?
Yes.
May 1st. Can you guys hear Sylvia okay? Say a few more words so they can get a test.
So what?
So they can get a test of whether they can hear you or not.
Oh, okay. Can you guys hear me? Can you hear me now?
Can
How
you
about
hear
now?
Me now?
Hey, can you hear me now? Cool. Okay, let me
we
know.
Should be
let
good.
Me know
yeah.
In the comments, because you know you want to hear every morsel I'm going to utter today.
All right, and that's enough and cut. Okay. All right, so we are watercoloring today. I'm so excited to be back to this. I know I have to apologize a little bit because, like, last week I mentioned we would be working on hydrangeas.
Yeah.
I lied.
Oh.
Because when I realized it was May Day and I haven't done watercoloring in a while, I kind of got a little nervous about doing something so detailed. So I feel like I need to build up to this. Do you mind?
May Day, posy.
Yeah, do you mind waiting?
Okay.
Like
no.
The build up to getting okay, yeah. Thank you. All right. Sylvia spoke for all of you. So so as long as sound is okay, we are good to go. I think we're gonna go ahead and say hello to everybody
say
in the audience.
To everybody. Okay, Liz is here and Lisa and Junk is here, Jules, Sarah. We have Andrew, who just had a birthday, so everybody wish him belated happy birthday wishes, if you haven't done so already. I'm sure he loves me saying that. And Kim is here. And let me see, make sure I've got everybody. I think that's it for so far.
So far. So as you show up to the show, please let us know that you're here by leaving us a comment in the audience, in the chat there. I got to tell you guys, there's somebody in the audience who isn't normally here. He's here live with us here in the building.
That's right.
But no one will know because he refuses to say anything or even make a sound.
He has to come over and at least put a hand in.
You would think he would, but he's still sitting on the couch ignoring me. So we'll just pretend.
We have Mr. Crafter.
Mr. Crafter is in the audience. I wish I had, you know what? I want to turn the camera just to show it to him, but whatever.
Behind the scenes. don't get me. Okay, BJ showed up. Hey, BJ. And Shilda Taylor.
All right. Well, welcome. We're glad you're here.
And Jazzy's here.
Woohoo.
They're coming in.
Okay, so I have just lightly sketched.
Don't I have a devotional?
Oh, my goodness. You're right. There's a devotional. I apologize.
Today's
message, please.
Okay, switch. Okay, today's message is, O Lord, keep your covenant of love with your servants who continue wholeheartedly in your way. That's 1 Kings 8:23. Beautiful verse.
You know, that's kind of crazy with everything that's going on in the world around us. It's kind of hard sometimes to remember that those who keep your covenants are still here. Please don't forget about us, Lord. That's the bottom line there, right? Don't forget about us. Things can get crazy.
Oh,
we
Carol
don't want to be forgotten.
Us.
Hello, Carol.
We haven't seen Carol in a while.
We're glad you're here.
Oh, super.
Okay, so here's what I got going on. Can I get back to the painting
okay, now?
All right, all right.
Now the lesson can begin.
All right, I have a sketch that you may or may not be able to see, hopefully. I purposefully left it a little bit darker than normal because I wanted you to see it before I do this next step, which is I have this kneaded eraser. that I'm just going to stretch
T-Dog
apart.
I think took a picture of that, didn't he?
I think so. I posted one before we went live, on Instagram. But I'm just going to take this kneaded eraser, and I'm just going to push on the paper and sort of bring up all of those harsh edges. Now, I will still be able to see some of that for my guide to be able to paint, but you probably won't see it on camera, and that's okay. It's just a rough guide.
Jules put a really nice thing, thank you, Jules, in Instagram. If you don't follow Jules, you need to follow her because she always has great things.
And it's really, we're really grateful that you have been sharing and promoting the Craft Shaak. We appreciate that, Jules.
She's sharing the Craft Shaak.
Thanks to everybody who shares. As a matter of fact, if you're thinking about it right now, go ahead and hit that share button as you're watching here, and you can share with those who may not be here yet, letting them know.
She's got some beautiful flowers. And she does beautiful work.
All right. I have my Daniel Smith colors out.
Ooh, yes.
I'm going to put them over here so you can see. There they are. This
are
is my palette.
Are those all Daniel Smith, or do you have more?
No, those are all Daniel Smiths. Okay. That's all that I have at this moment in my possession.
Oh, look at you.
And then I have, these are 2 M. Graham paints.
Where'd you get that ceramic plate?
Walmart.
It's just a regular...
This is a regular plate.
I like the shape
of
that.
Me too. So I've just got a couple of M. Graham paints over here too, because this is like a really bright yellow, and I'm almost out of the yellow on my Daniel Smith palette. And then this is a turquoise that's kind of opaque. So I'm going to just see what we're going to do here. But okay, I've got clean water. I've got my spray bottle. I've activated my paints. Let's get going. I'm going to just give this a spritz. Oh, I forgot to say what kind of paper this was.
Yes, what kind of paper is that, Heather?
It's Canson, but it's like Moulin.
Sure. Here, I'll key it in.
You can't see it. It's like the stamp. It's M-E... I don't know. It's the back. It's backwards.
Okay. Let's see if I can figure it out.
Yeah. It's Murray. Oh, there's a little bit of tint in my brush here. All right, so I just sprayed a little bit, and now I'm dragging it back and forth, and there's a little bit of pink tint in my brush here, but doesn't matter. Bottom line is just to get the surface wet. Very saturated here. And I just taped it down. It's, I think it's 300 pound.
Yeah, it feels like it.
And it's 140 cold press. So very typical of what we normally use here. All right. I'll let this set for just a minute. And I do have my image up on an angle. For you guys, it doesn't really look like one, but it's, I don't know what degree that is, but probably like 30 degrees, maybe 15, maybe any number you want to say. All right, what are we going to start with? Let's start by putting in just a little bit of quinacridone pink in where some of these flower shapes are. And you see how it just wicks away? See how that wicks? I'm just going to lightly dab in some
Moulin
of this
de
color.
Roy, or
thank
Dua.
You. Dura?
Yeah.
Dua?
Yeah.
See, I don't speak French. That's part of the problem.
Okay, I'll put a... Sorry.
No, that's all right. We'll just put it back over here. All right, is it just me or did all the lights go dark? What in the world? It got really dark in here. Wow, it got dark outside, so.
The sun just turned itself down.
I guess.
So it's too hot, too bright, to turn it down.
All right, so now I'm going into that yellow. No, I don't think they can hear you, T-Dog, and it's not necessarily great because you just sit over there to my right and mumble a lot, so.
I'm not mumbling.
You are mumbling.
I'm mumbling when I don't want you to hear me.
All right. So far, these are my...
Michael Daniels is here, too. Hi, Michael.
Hi, Michael. Glad you're here. So far, these are my areas of flowers. These are going to end up being a little purple.
Okay, Jules made a statement, and maybe she can clarify it for me. Didn't realize you could get Moulin de Wa watercolor paper. Good to know. Is that, like, only available in certain countries, or is it a special paper that
I
you're
no
aware
idea.
Of that...
I don't know. I just bought it.
When we were at...
I think I actually got that when I was at Dick Blick.
Oh, okay. Wasn't
a Jerry? Long time ago. Okay. No, a long time ago.
I'm pretty sure you have a ton of art supplies that are from a long time ago.
Yeah, almost everything I own is from a long time ago. Pretty much. All right, let's start adding in some of these leaf shapes, leaf things in here.
Now, when you activated your Daniel Smiths, you just sprayed some water on them?
Just sprayed them with the water bottle.
Jewel says she thought it was just for things like pastels and pencils.
No, No, they have, Canson has all kinds of papers. All kinds of papers. All right, we're going to go with an orange and make a coral. So I'm just mixing, let's see, this is pyrrole orange and quin pink, and it's going to make this like coral color. And I'm just going to put that in the base down here at the bottom of the table. This would be what our basket is sitting on. And very wet paper still, and I'm just using that to create these loose base colors. It's given us sort of a blocking in. You remember when we did the Bryce Canyon?
Yeah.
We just sort of blocked in color. It's kind of the same concept here. Remember our watercolors are going to dry back a little bit lighter. So,
Michael Ann is joining us too.
Well, hello, Michael Ann. Oops, can you tell that that's dry? Can you tell?
Yeah.
What's her name for the show?
I don't know what her name is. Did Lynn send any directions?
No, I didn't get any directions.
Oh.
Nope. So I'm just going in with a wet
week?
Brush.
No,
Garfield.
Garfield. She was Garfield.
Yeah.
Week.
Because last week we were working with the lasagna box, which, by the way, we finished that piece. I don't know if everybody saw that or not, but we finished it, and I did a video.
It was beautiful. Oh, my gosh.
So you guys can check that out. Okay, so now you may have noticed, because we're on an angle, things are running here. I'm just going to lightly dab that up.
Deborah Detour is her first time here.
Welcome.
Thank you for joining us, and we have Thea Boulan. Hi from the Netherlands.
Oh, welcome.
Awesome. Thank you for joining us.
All right. So I'm just going to cut in around some of these shapes very loosely. This is not precision here. Just very loosely. And I noticed there's a couple of spots you may be able to see. There's a couple of spots I haven't put any color in yet.
Kim says she's lurking, too.
Hi, Kim. Let's see how we go with this. All right. What I don't like is that I have this thing here. I wish I could take it off.
Jules says that she loved how the cover was finished, Heather.
Oh, yeah, that was fun.
Beautiful.
That was a fun project.
Yeah. Okay, we have Suni Laura. Hi from Michigan. Hey, welcome. I'm from Michigan. What part are you from?
All right, so I'm going to let this set down. That's going to create a mark, but we'll deal with it later. We don't care. Okay.
Okay. We have a question here.
Yeah.
We usually start at 11 o'clock.
What's the question?
Well, they want to know when Kraaft Shaak starts.
Oh, Kraaft It Live is noon Mountain Time or 2 p.m. Eastern every day, every Tuesday. Every Tuesday. So if you're in Pacific time zone, that's 11 a.m. If you're Mountain, 12, Central, 1, Eastern, 2. If you're
know,
in the U.K.,
yeah.
I think it's 7 o'clock at night.
I think hours Jules, depending on where. Yeah.
Jules, if you'll confirm that for us, please.
Yeah, and then in the Netherlands, let us know what time it is there
yeah,
for you.
We'd
yeah.
like to know. All right, so I'm just giving this a sort of a hit with the heat tool. It's just to give it a little bit of dry. It doesn't have to be completely dry at this point. We're just going to go in with some details now. And I think I'm going to brighten up some of these colors. I'm going to add some orange.
Jules says yes, 7 p.m. correct.
Yay, yeah. I got it right. So we're going to go in with a little
Laura
bit of
orange.
Cindy Laura
is from Hemlock, which is by Saginaw. I'm from Metro Detroit and ended up out my last few years there in Michigan and Cass Lake and Sylvan Lake and Elizabeth Lake area. So. And Michael's saying, you make this look so easy. Yeah, she does, doesn't she?
So we're just putting in shapes, just blobs, basically. That's all we're doing here. And
Thea is saying that she watches often, but she's a silent watcher.
Well, we like that you've let us know you're watching,
yeah,
even
nice.
If it's silent. Thank you.
Thea is saying it's 8:15 in the evening in the Netherlands.
All right.
There.
Good to know. Thanks, Thea. So I'm just going in now with the tip of the brush and just adding a little bit of detail to some of these. I'm going to leave this great big one here because that's going to be our focal, and we're going to work on that one in more detail.
Shilda saying that it's 7 p.m. in Ireland.
Oh, ooh,
in Ireland.
Wow.
Cool. I love it when people from all over the world join us.
Me
I think
too.
That is so cool.
Me too. That's one of my favorite parts about Kraaft It Live is it is a worldwide audience. But, you know, we only know that if you guys let us know. So thank you so much for sharing your location. What's really exciting is we are in the process of having a live on-location art concert. It's going to be happening really soon. At the end of May, we have our very first one. I mean, we did do this when we were in Montana, but it wasn't really official, you know? So kind of excited to have the opportunity to do the first official Kraaft It Live art concert here in Arizona. If you're watching and you happen to be in Arizona, we hope you'll look to the website for tickets. They should be being posted soon. I'm still working on making all that happen.
And it's a beautiful venue, too. Oh, my gosh.
It's gonna be amazing.
Yeah.
I really cannot wait. Cannot wait. All right, so again, I'm just adding a little bit of shape and definition to some of these things. As you can tell, it's still just blobs, right? I mean, at this point, we're still just doing blobs here and there. And you'll notice that I'm not using as large of a brush as I was before.
Yes.
And as we get further into details here, you'll notice that I will use smaller and smaller strokes.
Thea's saying that Ireland's not too far from the Netherlands, and she's a silent watcher too because she says her English is not that good. It's She's typing it in just beautiful.
Yeah, well, English is my first language, and mine's not so good either, Thea, yeah. So it's totally fine. You are welcome here, and you definitely are in the right place. Okay, so far it just looks like a bunch of dots and blobs, doesn't it? All right, let's get ourselves a little bit of a brown so we can work on this basket now. So I'm just going to take some, this is quinacridone burnt orange right here, and a little bit of this phthalo blue, and look at that brown it's going to make us. Can you see that brown? Maybe add just a little bit of permanent red to sort of warm it up a little bit. So now it's a little more brown-like. See that? We'll just use that. Cool. Add a little bit of water to it so it has a little bit more transparency. And we'll go in here. And we don't really care if it runs in with these other colors, because at this point we're still just in the blob stages.
Deborah wants to know, is your paint from tubes or cakes?
Yes. So all of these are actually from tubes originally. I didn't buy any pans, and this, I just put these out today. This one and this one, I put them straight out of the tube. So these have dried over couple years now. Yeah. And then I activate them with the spray bottle. But then these two, this, cobalt turquoise and this, or is that teal? I don't know. And then this yellow are from my M-gram tubes. So.
And Scrappy Days is here. Hi.
We are glad you're here. So T-Dog is snapping behind the scene pictures for Instagram. If you're new here, what we like to do is provide you with the opportunity to see some different angles, some closer imagery, close-up shots, things like that, as well as some behind-the-scenes shots you might not see otherwise. And T-Dog likes to do that.
He does a great job, too.
And he's waiting for me to move, so... Oh, I have to move the whole thing out of the way. Here I am just explaining away, and he's not taking a single picture. So sometimes we have to wait for him because he's like, you know, the perfect photographer. So let's see here. We've got just a little basket.
Oh, it is a basket. A basket of posies.
Something like that. All right, and as it would be if this were really a basket, we need to make sure that that handle is sort of hiding behind some of these other flowers, right?
Right.
All right, so let's just add some more color in here. And we'll just let it sort of fade out there. Okay. I think we're going to add just a little bit
of... That's nice that you did a basket. I was thinking you're going to do a vase, but I like a basket, so that's cool.
Well, I figured for May Day. I mean, I think over the years we've talked about May Day in different places of the world and what it means to different generations. And, you know, I didn't grow up celebrating anything to do with May Day. Today is... one of my cousin's birthday. That's the only thing I ever knew May 1st to be. It was his birthday. So
I'm originally from Michigan. I can remember in elementary school, May Day was a big thing, and we always did the maypole dance, where
yeah,
they had a pole.
I've heard this. We had
cray paper, and we taped it to the pole, and then you ran around and decorated the pole.
Yeah, see, that's cool. Fascinating to me, because I don't think we ever did something like this. Like, my school, they deprived me. What the heck? So I didn't like how soft and quiet this table or whatever the basket's sitting on is.
It's a picnic table.
Sure.
A red picnic table. Carol's saying she loves this so far.
All right, so we're just gonna darken up this side of it here.
Jazzy's saying that she did maple stuff too in grade school in Canada.
Oh, see? Canada had it going on. What in the world happened to my school?
And
I want my childhood back. How's that?
Yeah. It's his wife's birthday and Wonder Woman's birthday.
Coincidence? Yeah. I think not.
Well, happy birthday to your wife, Michael.
Yeah. Happy birthday to Sherry. I think I can say Sherry, right? I did already, so it better be okay. But all right, let's see. There we go. Just get that all out there. So you can probably tell that my basket sort of ran because, you know, things weren't dry yet. It doesn't matter because it's not detailed yet, so we're good. I think, though, should be ready to go up here. So we're going to switch to a different brush. So as we do this, we started with this great big one. Now we've gone down to this one. Now we're going to move down to the next one. This next size down, not much smaller, but a little bit. Going to go, let's just start with this orange. We'll go in here where this one is. And what kind of flowers are these? I don't know. We're going to try and figure it out as we paint them.
It doesn't matter. They're just posies.
That one's still wet, so I think we need to wait a little bit on that orange color. So we'll just wait. And we'll go in on these pinker ones here.
Watercolors with Michael is here. Hey.
Hi.
Lisa, sorry. I am so late. Okay,
that's
here.
All right, yeah. Just always glad to have you. I'm going to just add some details to these a little bit as we go. Just sort of lift some of this off and soften some of these edges, make it a little bit bigger in areas than it was at first, and see how that's sort of becoming a open bloom, pointed down.
A peony.
Sure. This one. Needs to be just a little bit more of a bud-like. Got some admiration of T-Dog's work over there.
Yeah, yeah, he's playing with the color. It's really cool.
Nice. All right, and some of these might even still be, this brush might still be a little bit too big yet for this. We'll see here as I go. I'm liking that. That's looking pretty good. Let's do something just a little bit. This one needs to be more purple. I thought that we wanted these to be pink down here, but they're going to be purple.
Yeah.
So they will.
Speaking of posies, you know, I've been posting pictures on my Instagram of all the trees that are in bloom and everything, because the spring is just beautiful in the desert.
Absolutely.
But my goodness, the sororals. I have never seen so many blooms on the tops of sororals.
Really? I've been having a hard time finding them. So
oh
you found
my gosh, they're all
everywhere. Over. Yeah, I'm telling you, I need to come live by you because I'm not seeing that here.
I can't believe it. It's just like their crowns are just, there's like hundreds of blooms coming out, and sororal blooms don't last long. They bloom like one day and then they're gone. But the scent is amazing. They're just absolutely gorgeous flowers.
All right, we're going to put a little bit more purple in here because we can't just have those two pointing out like that. That's just not going to work. So we're going to put a little bit up here and put a little bit up here behind this yellow one. We'll detail that in a little bit here. Let's do that for now. And we're going to put just a little bit right in here. Can you get another picture? I guess so.
Yeah, T-Dog's just a snapping away.
That's all right. It gives me a second to look at it and go, you know what? I don't think I like how that one is turning out right there. All right, that's enough purple for now. All right, I'm going to switch to a smaller brush, and I'm actually going to switch to a flat brush to do some more leaves. We're going to change a little bit of color too. Add some dimension in these leaves here, and I've got just a flat brush, and we're going to go in and add some different. Just let some of this stuff be a little bit, change up some of this a little bit. I don't know if that makes any sense, but.
Pretty.
All right, I like that. Okay, now back to another good brush. This is a new one.
I was going to ask you if you had used that yet.
This is Black Velvet.
Likes, right?
Yeah, Black Velvet. Part of the silver series. This one's number 8. Oh, the tip on this thing. I can see why somebody likes it. So let's work on that focal point. I think that's pretty dry, so let's work on that right now. So we're just going to go in with the tip, put in just a little bit. You know, when a blossom in the very center of the blossom, it's very tight and it's got some depth in there, like that's what that we're seeing there, right?
Yeah.
So now how do we just work with what we've got? So I've already got color down on there, and I'm just going to kind of outline some of that color, leaving some of the highlights that we've left wherever it's white, and then just defining some of these petals.
Sandra just joined us.
Hi, Sandra.
Are you home or are you still visiting?
One of the things that I really enjoy is finding the image in our blob. And if you've seen any of my, what did we call those, radiant florals, if you've seen any of those videos where I would paint those blobs into a flower, this is basically how I do that.
Well, I think that's so cool because you lay down the color and you put on different hues of the color, and then you come back and you define it.
And you just soften some of these edges, and it just sort of disappears into the bottom down there, and it creates that shadow, that curve. So you clean out your brush. You just sort of have a damp brush, really. That's all that is. No pigment on it now. Now we're just softening up that pigment we already put down.
Looks so nice.
See how that floral just became a floral right there for us. So let's see what else we can do. Let's add a few details here. Do some of the same things here. So we know that we can take just a little dab in the center and just sort of outline what we see already. We can leave that be, or we can soften it up like we did.
Michael Ann is saying that she's having a hard time with watercolors because she's so used to acrylic.
Yeah, it's definitely a different animal, for sure. You have to understand that you can't just go painting over it. I have such a hard time with acrylics because there isn't really a paint this first, paint that second. Like, the rules aren't there the same way. Mm-hmm. We're going to use just a little bit of purple. Darken some of this up here. Give us a little bit more definition inside of this one. That's kind of neat.
It's looking very pretty.
Keep going with some of these here. So you notice I just put down, you know, a blob of color, and then I just sort of go in once it's a little bit dry and add a little bit more color and more defined, use the point rather than as much of that, the belly of the brush. You just sort of keep doing that until it looks the way you want it to. I'm going to deal with those yellows and those oranges here in a bit. I like that. Mm-hmm. So you can't, I don't know if you can tell or not, but that yellow one is going to get really big and full in front of that purple one. This one, I think we'll have this one pointing up to the sky a little bit more than the rest have been. I love that you do these behind the scenes pictures, but man, do I have to wait every time, really? Can't you take any pictures with my hand in the way? Sometimes.
Sometimes your hand is in the way, and it's really in the way.
It's important to T-Dog to get it right.
It is, very yeah. important. Your hand should not be there, like, remove the painter.
Could you take your hand off, please?
Could you remove yourself from your painting?
If I had Photoshop, I'd get the eraser tool.
I'm liking how this is turning out.
I like all the colors.
Me too. Looks very springy.
Mm-hmm, very springy.
I would like to make a note that today's show is so incredibly relaxing that Mr. Crafter has fallen asleep.
Oh, I haven't turned around to see.
Yeah, well, don't look, because he is.
Aw.
This is by far the most boring show he's ever watched. And it's one of the only ones he's ever watched. Yeah, he's going to be great when we're on the road.
He's just tired from all that driving this weekend.
I suppose you're right.
On the other side of the state.
I suppose you're right. Yeah, if you follow us on Instagram, you've already seen the pictures I posted of where we went. It was absolutely beautiful. It was nice to get away because we've been working so hard and just trying to get ourselves on the road so we can come bring the art concerts to a city near you. And it has been... It's been a tedious time for us, and so getting away was nice. It was very nice.
And it's a pretty area you were in too.
Yeah.
Yeah. Deborah's saying it's absolutely beautiful. Big capital letters. Yay. She's loving it.
Yay.
Yay. Yeah, we got some really pretty places here in this state. The thing that's amazing about this state is down here in the desert, it gets really hot in the summertime, but then all you have to do is drive 90 minutes, and you can be up in the mountains, and you're 20, 30 degrees cooler.
90 minutes, really depending cool. on where you live, my dear.
Yeah.
Not 90 minutes from here.
Well, if you go out to Payson. How
yeah,
far
but
are you
it won't
Payson?
Be it won't be really cool. But yeah, you're right. It is very
get up until you start getting up on the rim and it really starts getting cool and you get up to Flagstaff. That's even cooler.
Yeah.
Very completely true. Different kinds of vegetation. It's pine trees and regular trees.
It's much more like where I'm from, you know, where we were living before in Butte. It's much more like that when you get up there. The elevation and the pine trees and all of that. It's so nice.
Well, I love it when we drive up to Flag and you start getting into the pines and the smell. Oh my gosh, the smell is just wonderful. It's like breaks my heart with that fire, that tinder fire that's going on.
I saw,
on.
Yeah.
You know, it's over and it was at Happy Jack and that's all pine up there. 8,000 acres have burned so far. So sad.
It's crazy. All right, how are we doing? How am I
doing?
We're
doing great on time and everything, so. As I look at my digital reminder.
Replacement, digital replacement.
My digital replacement.
Yeah, you forgot, I think. All right, let's see.
Nikki is here. This is a quick check-in. Hello, Shaak.
Hello,
hey,
Nikki.
Nikki.
Nikki's been all over the valley.
I know.
Awesome that you could join us today, Nikki.
You should have been here in person.
Yeah, what in the world?
Miss you, lady, miss you.
Yeah, we got spoiled having Nikki around. We don't want to do the show without her here now.
I know. She's such a sweetheart. Oh, this is really coming together nice.
See, now then, I get bounced out of the shot by T-Dog, and now he's asking me to get into the shot, and then I spilled water.
It's okay. It's just texture.
It's not your fault. Never would I say that it was your fault. I know better than that.
When's Nikki going to be home?
I would ask Nikki that question.
Nikki,
I don't
when
know.
Are you going to be home? Not that she's far away. I could probably swing by and say hi on my way home.
I really want this one to be very, very fluffy back there.
I like that.
See
That's
if we need
nice
to
one.
Add just
yeah.
a few more here, details
yeah.
here. More admiration
like
of T-Dog, T-Dog's pictures.
Of it, you know, that was real pretty right up there.
He'll be posting that on Instagram, I hope,
yeah.
at some point.
No, it's just for us.
Oh, he said no, it's just for us, haha.
Okay,
all right. What do we think of this so far?
It's beautiful. Everybody's loving it.
I think I'm just going to add some floral things in here. All right, let's see what that looks like. Let's pop in with some more of that yellow in this area here and make this one just a little bit more substantial. It's hard with yellow because it doesn't quite work the same way as the other colors where you can't really layer it on top of anything the way that you can with the other ones. But we can use a little bit of the red, sort of make some of those
Well, that's just like what Jules is saying. She says, I love how you make those flowers pop. And that's what you do. I mean, when you start doing all that detail work and they just come to life right before our eyes.
Well, I hope that it's sharing with folks that they can do just, you know, take a blob. I keep saying blob. I mean, that's the technical term, right? Blob.
Right. Yeah.
And then, you know, you just have a little patience. Let it dry a little bit. Go back in with a little bit more concentrated color. If you don't like that, then go in with a different color like we're doing here. Give these a little bit. These almost looks like a, what is that one called that you like, the ranunculus? Kind of has that multi-layer. Sort of let it bleed out there. Yeah, I like
wow,
that. That's looking really good right
yeah,
there. I like
filling,
when it does
yeah.
that. I'm going to do the same thing on this side over here, just a little bit. Mm. That looks really good there.
Mm-hmm.
I like that. Going to go in here with just a little bit of this darker, sort of added a little bit of purple.
Oh boy, did that really add the depth to that flower.
Just to give it a little bit mm-hmm. more shadow underneath some of those areas there. All right, and then we still have a few more of these that are just sort of faded out. And they're okay, they can be faded out, because if you think about it, they're not necessarily in the front, but the color is there. But they need more definition for sure. I'm just going to add a little bit there. Just a little bit there. This one needs to be more orange. Now I'm just sort of mixing colors, you know, a little bit of this color from that flower and a little bit of this color from that flower, and it's okay.
Is here. Lynn's
Yay.
Here. Yay, Lynn. Oh, we
all right,
we
can start all over now. Lynn's is here.
Wow. She's going, you missed a spot.
Never mind. We're not starting over.
Oh, missed having her here.
Agreed.
Yeah. Oh, and did you see her Mother Goose this morning?
I did see something. Oh. I was just scrolling through real quick, trying to make sure I got everything shared where it needed to be shared. I really, honestly, if anybody's out there watching and wants to help the Craft Shaak, the best thing you can do is share what we do, because I am having a heck of a time doing it all on my own.
Scrappy Days is saying, this is looking wonderful, Heather. I wish I could do that with watercolors. Practice, practice, yeah.
Well, I mean, honestly, all you have to do is get yourself some paper and, you know, have a tea dog nearby to push you out of the way.
Yeah.
That's also beneficial.
Yeah.
Get yourself some paper. Get yourself a brush. Don't be so worried about whether it's the best products or any of that. I know a lot of people will say, always start with the best, because then you'll be used to the best, and, you know, and don't worry about that, because a lot of people, that would prohibit them from ever doing it at all, because it just costs too much money. So don't let that stop you either. What I would like to see you do is put a brush in your hand, put some paper down, and just make a few marks. Use a lot more water than you think you need, and then just, you know, start putting down some marks and let it dry. You could do it on 4 or 5 different papers. Let it dry in between and then come back and turn those blobs into something. And you won't succeed the first time. That's just not going to happen. My first ones didn't look like flowers. They didn't. But what they will look like is you'll start to understand where you're putting the marks and what it does make it do. And then you'll be able to say, okay, that didn't quite work how I wanted it to. What can I do next time so it won't do that?
Aw, looks good.
And just practice, just like Sylvia said, it's just practice. Every time it's just practice. And you know what? Don't give yourself all this pressure to make a masterpiece. Every piece doesn't have to be hung up on the wall. Just
well, you know,
have
if you
fun.
Don't like it, you can always use it as a background for something else.
Oh my gosh, you can make bookmarks out of it, even
yeah.
if it's just, I mean, it ends up being abstract once you start cutting it down.
Yeah.
All right, let's finish this basket, shall we?
Let's weave that basket.
All right, I'm going to go ahead and same brush because I like the tip of it. And I'm just going to outline this.
Aww,
basket here.
Nice comments about T-Dog. They want a T-Dog to take pictures and help. And then Lynn's is saying, I know how you feel. I'd swap the slave for him. Aww.
Yeah, we do love our T-Dog. He has added to the show something none of us could do without him. Except for when he says things like that. Moving too much. I'm just painting.
No, I'm moving too much is what I said. Oh,
gotcha. I do need hearing aids, I think, because I don't hear half of what you tell me. At least not the stuff. At least not the stuff I don't want to hear anyway.
She's actually using a Canson Moulin watercolor, 300 pound.
I love how people want to bend me off to other people.
You love how people are bidding you off to other people?
Yeah, there you go.
I would never do that. Oh, they sure do want to use you. For sure, bud. Yeah, it really got strange there, didn't it? Like, I think we crossed a line, maybe.
No.
So I'm just adding details of the handle here. Remember, all that foliage is coming in and around it, so it doesn't have to be too detailed. No worries.
Jules is saying, T-Dog, those close-ups are stunning.
And we'll add a shadow here, just underneath and off to the side a little bit.
Cool.
All right.
Lynn's is saying, T-Dog, let's just say, if you're ever in London, you're very welcome.
If we go to London, I won't be able to get him back home, I don't think.
Oh, I'd love to go to London. Oh, my gosh.
Like, I'm pretty sure it would be very difficult to make sure I brought you home.
I don't want to go to Prague.
You want to go to Prague?
I want to go to Prague and I want to go to London.
Okay.
Like,
yeah, it sounds almost like it'll be the Beatles or something. All right, that's where I like that. We're going to just leave that there.
Yeah.
Just add a little bit of loose water in there. Sort of mix that around so we don't have that sharp
Junk
edge.
Junk is saying he wants to go to Budapest, but he says Prague is nice.
Get a little bit of round going on that basket there. Okay.
Wow.
That pretty much does it for me in this basket.
Oh, it's just beautiful, Heather.
I'm sure I've talked myself in the Instagram.
Aw. Lynn's saying, I want to go to the next Kraaft Shaak concert. Yeah, we want you here too, Lynn.
Yeah, no joke. No joke.
Lynn's ever came to America, I'd never let her leave.
I would have to agree with you on that. There'd be no letting
no,
her
she'd
leave.
She'd be kidnapped. She'd be held here. I wouldn't let her go.
Duct tape and door locks? Is that what you said, T-Dog?
Yeah, duct tape and door locks.
All right. Well, there you go.
Andrew's saying Budapest is really nice, too. He's been quiet. He must be still eating birthday cake.
All right, so.
Okay, all right.
Getting rid of her, is that exciting, huh, slave?
That's okay.
We will take it.
Yeah, we'll take it.
All right, so now I'm doing what I would call a dry brush over the top of this, but it is still a little wet, so it's not technically a dry brush, but I just want to add a little bit of texture to this.
Yeah, so it's not so flat.
Yeah, I just don't like how flat it is. So I think that's pretty good.
It's gorgeous. It's gorgeous, that says. It's gorgeous.
I think we're going to call that one done. So let's take this off. See how terrible my line is on there? But it's not that bad, actually. It didn't turn out too bad. All right. We're going to take the tape off so we can see this finish. So this was me makeshifting because it's the only board I had that wasn't occupied by another art piece.
I
had to use my drawing board.
And every board is...
Yeah, I'm sort of in the process, so. Just removing the masking tape.
I love the decal.
I know, it's like a magical reveal or something. Okay, I'm getting stuck here. Here we go. Let's remove this.
Oh, Lynn,
this
you don't have to worry. There'd be no take-backsies at all.
No take-backsies?
You stay with me, cuz.
All right, here's our finished piece.
Isn't that beautiful?
Happy May Day, everybody.
Wow.
What do you think? What do you think?
It's gorgeous.
All right, let's sign it and call it quits.
BJ saying it's great, Heather. Love this.
All right, there you go, everybody.
Oh,
there's
so pretty.
Our May Day basket of flowers. Hope you enjoyed loose. Oh, you want to go to Instagram? T-Dog has just taken some more photos. You know, I'd love to see it if you decided to play along with some loose watercolors and, you know, and show us your mess-ups, too, because I mess up with these all the time. I've even shown them on Facebook and on Instagram all over the place. Speaking of Facebook, did you know that we have a new Facebook group for those of you who play over on Facebook? If you don't play on Facebook, don't worry about it. But if you do and you'd like to join the crafters group, you are welcome to ask to join. It is a closed group, which means you will only be able to interact if you are a member. And that keeps all of our members safe and it makes for a very happy area for everybody to enjoy. But if you'd like to join us, let me know. Join us there. All right. Hopefully you like this. Give this a thumbs up if you did. We're going to be working on hydrangeas at some point. I believe next week. I think I'm comfortable enough to do it now.
Yeah.
So, all right.
Yeah, excellent.
Sounds
great
good.
Show.
Thanks for joining, everybody. Oh, there's a thumbs up from T-Dog. We can now officially end the show. Thanks, everybody. I hope you have a very crafty day.
Bye, everyone.
Bye now.
Thank you.